I just want to make sure it's actually starting.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our Wednesday morning 10 a.m. healing service. We will be following the Book of Common Prayer for this. We're doing a slightly adjusted service from the Book of Common Prayer. We begin with the Rite to Eucharist service. I think it's 355 in the BCP. Don't worry if you don't have it in front of you. You can just follow along with us. Tim and I are here together in the church. Tim is graciously taking care of the filming, which is really wonderful. So we will begin with just a moment or two of silence. So we begin on page 355 of your Book of Common Prayer. Tim, I think that we should stand.
Okay.
Sorry.
Okay.
Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins. His mercy endures forever. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Let us pray. Pour your grace into our hearts, O Lord, that we, who have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, announced by an angel to the Virgin Mary, may by his cross and passion be brought to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So Tim has our first reading, which is from the book of Isaiah.
A reading from Isaiah 7, 10 to 14. Again the Lord spoke to Ahaz, saying, ask a sign of the Lord your God. Let it be deep as Sheol, or as high as heaven. But Ahaz said, I will not ask, and I will not put the Lord to the test. Then Isaiah said, hear then, O house of David, it is too little for you to weary mortals that you weary God also. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Look, the young woman is with child and shall bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel. The word of the Lord.
So our, in place of a psalm today, we have the Magnificat, the Song of Mary, and you can find it on page 91 of your Book of Common Prayer, page 91. Tim and I will read it together. I think it's on that sheet also that I gave you.
Oh, yes it is.
Sorry, I keep bending down.
Yeah.
All right.
Let us read together. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation.
He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit.
He
has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly.
He
has filled the hungry with good things,
and
the
rich
he has
sent away empty.
He has come
to the help of his servant Israel,
for
he has remembered
his
promise
of mercy,
the promise he made to our fathers, to
Abraham,
and
his
children
forever.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son. And you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth in her old age has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month for her, who was said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to God.
So, instead of having a regular saint day, as we usually do in these Wednesday services, today is the Feast of the Annunciation of our Lord, March 25th. So, we get to have a little bit of Advent here in March, which is kind of nice, to be honest. Today's feast commemorates how God made known to a young Jewish woman that she was to be the mother of his son, and how Mary accepted her vocation with perfect conformity of will. It has been said, God made us without us and redeemed us without us, but cannot save us without us. That's beautiful. God made us without us and redeemed us without us, but cannot save us without us. Mary's assent to Gabriel's message opened the way for God to accomplish the salvation of the world. It is for this reason that all generations are to call her blessed. The Annunciation has been a major theme in Christian art in both East and West. Innumerable sermons and poems have been composed about it. The term coined by Cyril of Alexandria for the Blessed Virgin, Theotokos, the God-bearer, was affirmed by the General Council of Ephesus in 431. Mary's self-offering in response to God's call has been compared to that of Abraham, the father of believers. Just as Abraham was called to be the father of the chosen people and accepted his call, so Mary was called to be the mother of the faithful, the new Israel. She is God's human agent in the mystery of the incarnation. Her response to the angel, "Let it be to me according to your word," is identical with the faith expressed in the prayer that Jesus taught, "Your will be done on earth as in heaven." Gerald Manley Hopkins compared Mary to the air we breathe. He writes, "Wild air, world mothering air. Of her flesh, he took flesh. He does not take flesh and fresh. Wild air, world mothering air. Of her flesh, he took flesh. He does take fresh and fresh, though much the mystery how. Not flesh, but spirit now, and makes, oh marvelous, new Nazareths in us, where she shall yet conceive him morning, noon, and eve, new Bethlehems, and he born there evening, noon, and morn." So this idea, God is making new Nazareths in us, and Mary may yet conceive Jesus, morning, noon, and eve, new Bethlehems. He be born again in us, day after day. This is beautiful. So I think the point here is that Mary bore Jesus once, but the presence of Jesus is being born again and again within our flesh. It's a beautiful poem. And that quotation at the beginning, "God made us without us and redeemed us without us, but cannot save us without us." You know, that's a twist on free will. Often we struggle with the idea, if God is omnipotent, if God is all powerful, why is there suffering in the world? And this is an explanation for that. God made the world of God's own volition. God does not need our help or our assistance in making that happen. Again, God redeemed us without us. God's grace is not dependent on us. There's nothing that we can do to earn God's grace or to turn away God's grace, to say to God, "Your grace is not sufficient in this situation." We can't say that. However, there is a role that we play in salvation, and it's a role that begins with Jesus, that we have that presence of God within us, and we are enabled by Mary saying yes to say yes ourselves. So this is very beautiful. It's nice to have a little of this season of Advent visiting us in Lent. There's something about the time that we're going through, this isolation, which is making the whole world sort of feel like a microcosm. We had a vestry meeting last night, and it was really refreshing to me to get to normal business. Of course, we were on Zoom. We've never had a vestry meeting before on Zoom, so that part of it was new. But it was nice to think, you know, the business of the church is going on. And I was very mindful of the fact that the last time we'd been together as a vestry was for our annual vestry retreat that we did at the end of February. And it seems like a world away. That seems like it was 6 months away or something. I think I, for one, am in this weird sort of time warp where, you know, having my children home when it's not a holiday and all of this just strange activity happening, it's sort of time. time, the year is sort of collapsing in on itself a little bit. And so it seems very appropriate that we're looking at the Annunciation right now. One of the points made is that has always been a great deal of art and poetry about Mary. And one of the things that we were doing a few nights ago as a family, we were just listening to music, something that we don't often do. And I was listening to Peter Gabriel. I just said, Alexa, play Peter Gabriel. And the song that came up was Mercy Street. And I loved Peter Gabriel. I went to see Peter Gabriel in college my freshman year. Peter Gabriel was huge in my sort of musical upbringing. And but I heard a line that I had never heard before. I didn't realize how deeply Christian Mercy Street is. The name obviously should be a giveaway. Dreaming of the tenderness of kissing Mary's lips. And that line just really struck home for me, that sense of God offering mercy. In that moment of the incarnation, of the Annunciation, of kissing lips. How beautiful. So, in our modified service, we are going to move on with the Nicene Creed. We don't often do that in our service, but there's something about being able to affirm what we believe together in the familiar word, which seems very important to me. And then we'll move on to our prayers of the people and very much our healing prayers for our congregation. So the Nicene Creed is found on page 358 if you want to follow along, or you can just listen with your ears and with your heart to Tim and me singing it. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. So the prayers that we're going to be using a modified version of prayer form 2. It's the one that we've been using on Sunday. One of the things that we're being especially mindful of in this time is taking prayer concerns from our congregation. And as the weeks progress, we're adding more and more names to our list. We're going to begin now, and in the silences between each bidding, please add your own prayer concerns, we shall begin now. I ask your prayers for God's people throughout the world. We pray for presiding Bishop Michael, for our own Bishop Megan, We pray most especially for our sisters and brothers in this church family, all members and friends of St. Paul's. We pray for our clergy. We pray for our lay leadership, especially our vestry, and all those who are not able to be physically present with us as we gather for worship. In these trying times, we pray you open our eyes to see new pathways for our ministry to the world around us. We pray for all ministers and people of your church, wherever we find ourselves today. Pray especially for the staff of the Office of the Bishop, both in Sacramento and also the staff of our presiding bishop. I pray that you strengthen them as they seek to chart a course for this diocese and for the whole Episcopal Church. I ask your prayers for peace, for goodwill among nations, that there may be peace where there is strife, and that you will guide the leadership of this and every nation for the well-being of all people. Gracious God, we pray especially for those countries that have been in the news and are not now, that are not in our thoughts because of that we are all being consumed by news of our own health and welfare in relation to the coronavirus. Lord, we pray for the people of Syria, Afghanistan. We pray for people who are suffering from war, the refugees that are, their plight has not been alleviated, Lord, and I pray that you help them stay in our minds and in our hearts. Lord, we pray for all of our elected officials, especially Donald, Gavin, James, and Leah. We pray that they will act with wisdom and resolve for the well-being of our communities. Lord, we pray for justice and peace throughout your world. I ask your prayers for the poor, the sick, the hungry, the oppressed, and those in prison. We pray for those in any need or trouble. We pray for the staff, volunteers, and clients of Reach for Home. Lord, I pray especially for Colleen and Rick and Dondi, Anna, Jackie, Jim. We pray for all of those who are striving to care for those people who have no homes in which to shelter in place. We pray for Healdsburg Shared Ministries, Roger Dormeyer and Yvonne, Faye Smith, Beth Greenwald, all those on the board of Healdsburg Shared Ministries. Lord, I pray that you guide them in their decision making. We pray for our own shower ministry. Most especially, we pray for Beth and for Jane, who are able to keep the shower ministry going right now. Lord, I thank you for their ingenuity and their courage so that they can meet this need that is vital to the people who are not able to shower in any other way. And Lord, I give you special thanks for Raquel and Marcella as they continue to clean our facility to make it safe for our employees and all those who come to the parish hall for ministry. Lord, we pray for all those who have been commended to our prayers for support and healing. We pray for Krista, Boone, David, Elizabeth, Emily, Jake, Jane, Leah, Zayla, Tom, Christopher, Joan, Elizabeth, Nancy, Johnny, Joyce, Myrna, Yvette, Catalina. Lord, in our congregation, cycle of prayer. We pray for Meg and Ken Brown. We pray for Bill Bergman and for Catherine and Grant Brophy. Lord, we pray for all those who are on our hearts and minds right now. Lord, we pray for all of those around the world who are ill from the coronavirus, and we pray for all medical professionals who are caring for them. Lord, as our schools resume, I also lift up especially to you teachers everywhere and students everywhere. Lord, I pray that you give them all patience and perseverance for the changes that have come over their routines, Lord, and I pray that this will be a time of great learning and deep learning and new learning that will benefit all of your people as we come together and learn in new ways. I ask your prayers for all who seek God or a deeper knowledge of Him. Pray that they may find and be found by Him. I ask your prayers for the departed. We pray for all those who have died. Rolando, Howard, Andrew, Smith, Tom, Dudley, Mary, Sam, and Harry, Ben. Gracious God, we pray for all those whose lives have been disrupted by confinement and cancellations, for workers and business owners everywhere who are experiencing loss of income, and for those who are anxious and afraid. In the midst of these hardships, we thank you for uniting us together within Christ's body and for assuring us that nothing can separate us because of your love for us all. We pray we are united again soon in one another's company. We praise God for those in every generation in whom Christ has been honored. And we pray that we may have grace to glorify Christ in our own day. Almighty God, to whom our needs are known before we ask, help us to ask only what accords with your will, and those good things which we dare not, or in our blindness cannot ask. Grant us for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So, according to the rubric that we are following, after the prayers of the people, a hymn or anthem may be sung and the offerings of the people received. So, what I would like to do right now is play an anthem for all of you. I'm grateful to have this opportunity to be here virtually with you. And Tim, it's always great to be here with you. I was telling him the other day at Bible study, it's really lovely to have a colleague in this, especially, and this is one of the beauties of having colleagues, is we don't all have the same skill set, and it is really nice to have a colleague with different skill set. So, Tim, I appreciate you stepping up to the plate here as a vestry member and lay leader of St. Paul's Church. I want to call your attention to our webpage. We are able to accept PayPal offerings on our webpage, and any offering is very greatly appreciated there. And continue to look for me at 10 a.m. on for a daily devotional. I've been broadcasting from the library here at church, so that'll happen every day at 10. Also, we are broadcasting our Sunday service at 10. We're in the process of figuring out what Holy Week is going to look like here at St. Paul's Church. So that is a work in progress, and we'll be in touch and make sure that our congregation and everybody on Facebook knows what our service schedule is going to be and how we are going to gather for worship in Holy Week. Now, during this anthem, though, I am going to play Mercy Street by Peter Gabriel, and then we will conclude with the Lord's Prayer saying together and a blessing. So I'm going to move a little closer here, hit play for Peter Gabriel's Mercy Street.
Thank you.
was a first. As I was playing that, it occurred to me, I mean, maybe there's some copyright issue that we should have thought about.
Yes, there is.
So I want to give a special shout out to Peter. Thank you for sharing your music and ministering to us this morning at St. Paul's. A special thank you. So we are going to conclude with the Lord's Prayer. Let us say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Live without fear. Your Creator has made you holy, has always protected you, and loves you as a mother. Go in peace to walk the good road, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you now and always. Amen.
Amen.
Let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Thanks be to God.